5, and it's to 29. And in addition to all the beautiful contributions so far made, I think the summary of it all here is that love shares. Love shares. If you love someone, you share with your family. Which is why we want to ask, because we want to share, we want that fellow to stand. In John 3:16, the Bible says, God so loved, he gave. And God doesn't give, he gave all. He gave his only begotten Son. Love shares. Shares gives. Love shares information. In John chapter 15, verse 15, John 15, verse 15, Jesus Christ says, I'm no longer calling you servants, I call you friends, because everything that God has shown me, I've shown you. I share the information that I get from my Father with my friends. In John 13, from verse 21 to 26, John 13, 21 to 26, at the Last Supper, when Jesus Christ was talking about who would betray him, and he wasn't going to tell the name of the fellow in public, the Bible says Peter beckoned to John. We know you are his favorite. What he won't tell others, he will tell you. And he told him, the deeper the love, the greater the depth of revelation. And if you read the book of Revelation, the whole book talking about things that will happen more than 2,000 years later. It was revealed to John the Beloved. Love shares, gives, it shares information, it shares ability. It says here, my Father enables me to do mighty things in the world. Enable me to do even greater than you have seen thus far. Another place he said, the Son can do nothing of himself, but whatsoever he sees the Father doing, that's what he does. Ability. Like someone mentioned in John chapter 14, verse 12, John 14, verse 12, Jesus Christ said concerning us that the works he did, we shall do also, and greater works. Love shares ability. Ability to do mighty things. But just one thing more is that love gives advance warning. Because he is here, he's telling us that the day is coming when those who are dead will hear his voice. then there will arise some to everlasting life, some to punishment or judgment. Warning. Advance warning. In Matthew 24, you can read the whole thing from verse 1 to 31. Matthew 24 from verse 1 to 31. The Lord told us the summary of everything that will happen at the end of days. In verse 25, there he said, "Lo, I have told you before. I have told you in advance." In John chapter 14 from verse 1 to 3, John 14 from verse 1 to 3, he said, "In my let not your heart be troubled. You just believe in God, believe also in me." He said, "In my Father's house there are many mansions. If it were not so, I have told you. I won't hide this from you. Now I'm going to go and prepare a place for you. When I finish preparing the place, I will come again." Advance information. And then in Matthew 24 verse 43, he made it clear, hey, watch, because you don't know the time when the Son of Man will come. In 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 verse 2, 1 Thessalonians 5 verse 2, the Bible tells us that it's going to come like a thief in the night. It will come like a thief in the night. So he said, watch. In Mark chapter 13, we read it from verse 33 to 37. Mark 13 from verse 33 to 37. It says, "What I said to one, I say to all. Watch. Watch. He loves you so much, he's telling you, watch. Because the end will come and come like a thief in the night. We are in that end times. And the unfortunate thing is that at the time we are supposed to be watching, we are growing more and more careless. A man of God, now of blessed memory, came to visit a friend here in Nigeria. After spending a couple of days, he said, "It does not appear as if you are expecting the Lord to return." He saw the prosperity. He saw the comfort. He listened to the sermons. That everything is about now. 7 steps to success, 3 steps to breakthroughs, etc., etc. He said, "It looks as if they are not even expecting the Lord to return." Watch. The end is nearer than you think. The Bible says, "Now is our salvation closer than when we first believed." My prayer is that because he loves us so much that he has given us advance warning, we will take that warning seriously. Amen. Because it's coming from someone who loves us. Amen. And from now on, we keep watching. Amen. I think I said some time ago, at least those of you who are close to me, you will find that my last prayer every night as we gather together, the last statement. If I ask you, what will that statement be? If you arrive before tomorrow, please don't leave us behind. Every day, I've been praying that prayer. What does that mean? And tomorrow morning, some of us might be gone. And some might be left behind. I pray you will not be left behind.
Amen.
I told this story once upon a time. I was president of the Pentecostal Fellowship of Nigeria. And all the Pentecostal pastors, bishops, and so on had a meeting there at the camp. And a preacher was asked to come and preach on the second coming of Jesus Christ. He preached a fantastic sermon, taking it in details. We are not in a hurry. He was given as much time as he wanted. Signs of his coming. What will happen when he comes? What will happen after he has gone? And etc. etc. When he finished, everybody was very sober. As the president, I had to make a comment. I said, there's only one thing I want to add to what our brother has said. Because it was very, very eloquent, very detailed. I said, for somebody who leaves this world before Jesus returns, the day he dies, his own second coming has come. Because there'll be room for no more room for manure. That's one point he mentioned. When the time comes, there's no time for you to say, I will change, I will repent, I will restitute. So the trumpet sound, that's the end of the story. So I said, for the one who dies before he saw return, that's his own second coming. We finished the meeting, I traveled to America, came back 2 weeks later. The first information I got from one of the bishops who was at the meeting was, sir, do you know the preacher who preached on the second coming has died? He was a young man, much, much younger than I. You must watch. May God give you the grace to watch.
Amen.
Every time I look around, I open the door and I will pray. If I am a lawsi, buffering, I will not open the door. If I am for my mirror for the phone. If you are my phone, I never fell on Lord. I'm buying a book or a true. No, I don't know. We're only a fine at a phone and it's open. I'm buying a retro. She's not here. I'm pretty old. I love you. I do my anyway. Okay, Lord. So you tell you about failing you. I should go. Why you chief to talk about what? I see the cacao see that I will make it to money for you. I'm talking about my body. I never meet. I stop it. I remember to get my face or leave where my suburban mirror. Because you're not going to be able to do it. You're not going to be able to do it.
Ọmọ dẹ̀ ń bọ̀ o.
Ọlọ́run fúnra ẹ̀, Ọlọ́run bàbá. Ó máa fi àṣírí kan ṣoṣo yẹn, ó fi pamọ́. Torí Jésù fúnra sọ pé ìgbà àti àkókò tọ́mọ Ọlọ́run máa padà ni. Pé kò sẹ́ni tó mọ̀ ọ́, àwọn angẹ́lì tó wà lọ́rùn ò mọ̀ ọ́, òun fúnra òun ò mọ̀ ọ́, ká ló mọ̀. Ẹ ò ní lọ sọ pé bàbá nìkan ló mọ̀. Àwọn ọmọ ṣe máa ń gbàdúrà láàlálẹ́ ká tó sùn bá parí àdúrà wa, bá máa parí àdúrà tó o bá dé kójú ọ̀la ó tó mọ́. Bàbá jẹ́ ọmọ fi wálẹ̀ lọ. Mo ti ń gbàdúrà yẹn báyìí láti gbà tí mo ti máa pé Jésù ń bọ̀, ó sì ti tójọ́ mẹ́ta. Tí n bá dẹ̀ ń gbà láàrin oyè kẹtì máa pé mo ń gbà ní kọ̀rọ̀ fúnra mi. Ká ṣọ́ra, ká sì máa ṣọ́nà. Wọ́n bọ̀ ó. Ká lọ gbàdúrà. Ẹ̀jẹ̀ kọ́ bọ́ lẹ̀ bá mi ò lójú mọ́ rẹ̀ Àwa ń bẹ̀ yín ni o, Ọlọ́run alágbára, ẹ má jẹ́ àsorin kú. Orun tá a máa sùn tá à ní gbọ́ ìpè Olúwa ẹ má jẹ́ àsùn o. Ìgbàkigbà tẹ bá dé Olúwa ẹ jẹ́ ká wà ní ìmúra sílẹ̀ o. Ọjọ́ òní ẹjọ́ dára fún wa o. Oṣù yìí ẹjọ́ dára fún wa. Ìrànlọ́wọ́ láti ọ̀run wá tó máa ń kéèyàn ó ṣe àṣeyọrí rere Olúwa ẹ̀wà ara sí wa. Ẹ ṣàánú gbogbo àgbáyé o, ẹ ti wà mú tó kún lọ ní orúkọ Jésù Kristì Olúwa wa.
Bless you all.
Amen.
You be.